أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله الطيبين الطاهرين وعلى أصحابه المنتجبين وعلى جميع الأنبياء والمرسلين. قال الله تعالى في القرآن الكريم بعد: أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن هدى للناس وبينات من الهدى والفرقان فمن شهد منكم الشهر فليصم. صدق الله العلي العظيم. In the name of Allah, most gracious, most merciful, all praise is due to our Creator, our Cherisher, our Nourisher and our Sustainer. We bear witness there's none worthy of worship but Allah. We bear witness we believe in all the prophets, and we bear witness that Prophet Muhammad ibn Abdullah Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa ashabihi wa sallam is the final of all the emissaries of Allah. Respected elders, huffaz, ulama, qurra, teachers, brothers and sisters, respected youth, I greet you with the Islamic universal greeting of peace. May the peace, the mercy, and the blessings of Allah be upon each and everyone at this important hour of Jumu'ah in this holy month of Ramadan. I greet you. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. We are alhamdulillah in the month of Ramadan, a month which Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam referred to as Shahrum Mubarak, a blessed month that contains a night greater than 1,000 months. It's the month of revelation of the glorious Quran. And that month contains a most special night, which is also mentioned in the Quran, like the month is mentioned in the Quran. And we realize that though the first thing that comes to our mind when we think of Ramadan is Siyam, but the verse pertaining to Ramadan actually links the notion of Ramadan first to the Quran and then to Siyam. شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن. Ramadan is the month in which the Quran was revealed. هدى للناس وبينات من الهدى والفرقان فمن شهد منكم الشهر فليصم. In other words, Ramadan is a month in celebration of the revelation of the glorious Quran, and that Quran which came as a source of guidance for all of humanity until the end of time. And it is بينات, it's a clarification of those things that people may not be clear about or may be confused or confounded about. And it is al-huda, it is the guide, the source of guidance, al-furqan, the criterion and the standard of judgment and distinguishing between right and wrong. And then Allah says, فَمَنْ شَهِدَ مِنْكُمُ الشَّهْرَ فَلْيَصُمْ. Whoever witnesses that month of the revelation of the Quran should fast on that month. And therefore, one of the pillars of Islam, you know, Bunya al-Islam ala khams, shahadati an la ilaha illallah wa anna Muhammadan Rasulullah wa iqam as-salah wa ita'i zakah wa sawmi Ramadan wa hijjul bayt liman istata'a ilayhi sabila. One of the five pillars is that of fasting in the month of Ramadan. So this month of the Quran, this month of the commemoration of the revelation of the Quran, that Quran as a scripture, as a holy book, forms the bedrock of Islamic ideology and of Islamic teachings. And we believe that the Quran contains the commandments of Allah in its pristine, pure form, preserved. And it is considered the criterion for truth, the standard for justice, and the balance of what is good and bad. The Quran is referred to as Al-Kitab, the book, much greater than merely the collection or the combination of ink and paper. It is the book which is the musical score of Islamic spirituality, a book whose mere recitation is considered as an act of worship. It is called al-dhikr. Inna nahnu nazzalna al-dhikr. We have revealed al-dhikr, the Quran as a dhikr, as a reminder. And it's considered to be the last divinely revealed message sent to humanity, completing the spiritual arc of revelation that began from the time of Adam alayhi salam through Nuh, Ibrahim, Musa, Isa, and concluding with Muhammad, may Allah's peace be upon all of them. And the Quran therefore serves as a dhikr, as a reminder on a daily basis for us, but also as a reminder of the universal principles that were referred to in previous scriptures that were sent down to guide humanity throughout history. And the Quran therefore serves as a historical document testifying to past events and as a map for greater living for contemporary society and future societies. It is Al-Quran, which means the reading. The word Quran means the reading or that which is recited. The Quran is the most often read book in the world. It is the most memorized book in its entirety and perhaps the most quoted book in the world. It is the only book that is a science, tajweed, evolved regarding its recitation. And this facilitates the rhythmic and musical intonations with which we read the Quran. It is the last of Allah's revelation conveyed to humanity through the final messenger. No prophet to come thereafter, and no Quran or no revelation to follow. Muslims consider the commands of this Quran as a profound source, as a well, as a spring of wisdom, and as a guide in all matters of principle in our daily lives. And though the Quran is clothed in human language, a language which we speak, it is the ultimate ethical code and it is the primary source of law from Allah or primary source of divine law. It affirms all the fundamentals of past scripture and it contains the highest of standards by which we can judge and by which we can distinguish. We relate to the Quran by engaging the Quran. And if you truly want to benefit from the Quran, scholars have suggested 5 steps that we need, each one of us, not only those who are huffaz, not only those who are ulama, but each and every Muslim, what they call ilaqa bayn al-mu'mini wal-Quran, the relationship between the believer and the Quran. And the first one of that is belief and honor, ta'zeem. Iman wa ta'zeem, to believe in the book, that this is the ultimate book, that no law can supersede this book. Not only that, we have such kind of takreem or respect for the book, we try to be in a state of ablution even when we read it, engage it, or touch it. Then it comes to the tilawa, alladhina ataynahum al-kitaba yatluna wa haqqa tilawati. Besides believing it and honoring it, we ought to recite it to the best of our ability. And we must realize the Quran was communicated to Rasulullah in an oral fashion. It was a Quran which was a recitation, recited to the Rasul, which he recited to the companions around him, and it was transmitted through history. Though there is writing, there are recordings, but it's primarily an oral transfer and an oral transmission. So we should learn to read the Quran to the best of our ability, read it properly. Those to whom we have sent the book, الَّذِينَ آتَيْنَاهُمُ الْكِتَابِ يَتْلُونَهُ حَقَّ تِلَاوَتِ. They read it and recite it the way it ought to be recited. And therefore, there's even blessings just purely in reading the book, even looking at the book, but reading the book, the part of the tilawa or the qira'ah. Then comes the understanding, the tafakkur and the tadabbur, the reflection on the Quran, reflecting on the meanings and the understanding of the Quran. And many Muslims learn to read the Quran, very few strive to understand the book. Since the Quran is primarily a book of guidance, it is a book of rahmah, it is a book of hidayah, it is a book of barakah, but primarily a book of hidayah, a book of guidance, we have the responsibility to the best of our capacity to understand its message and reflect on it. And then, besides believing it, honoring it, reading it properly, trying to understand it, it's important, hukm wa iqama, to establish its rules and to live by it. One of the greatest duties we have is to live by the commands of the Quran. And the primary reason why Allah sent the revelation was for it to be a source of guidance to be implemented by people and those who proclaim faith. And then, tabligh wa tabeen, we have the responsibility of conveying the message and making it clear to others to the best of our ability as well. Each Muslim has the responsibility of conveying the message of Islam to others. بَلِّغُوا عَنِّي وَلَوْ آيَةً. Convey my message, the Rasul said, even if you only know one verse. The Prophet's wife said, Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha described the Rasul and said about him, كَانَ خُلُقُوا الْقُرْآنِ. In other words, he did not only convey the Quran in reading, but also in his example, in his personality, and therefore his wife radiallahu anha said, كَانَ خُلُقُوا الْقُرْآنِ. His character is the Quran. And therefore, a believer is not one who merely reads the Quran. Many of us just end up, how many khatams we've made. Alhamdulillah, we do very good. But we know how far we are in the Quran, but how much of the Quran is in us? And how much of what the Quran is in us is reflected through us? And therefore, one of the poets read Allah Abadi, he said, Akbar Allah Abadi said, Ye raaz kisi ko nahi maaloom ke mu'min qari nazar aata hai haqeeqat mein hai Quran. Mawlana Akbar Allah Abadi says, many people don't know, strange phenomena, though you see a believer reading the book, he himself actually is the book, because the book is dormant on the shelf, it becomes activated by our recital, it becomes alive and manifested by our behavior. So the Quran is a source of guidance for humanity. And though, as we mentioned, clothed in human language is the ultimate source of guidance till the end of time. Sayyidina Ali Karramallah Wajha said about this unparalleled source of wisdom of the Quran. He said, وَعَلَمْ أَنَّ هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ وَالنَّاصِحَ الَّذِي لَا يَغُشْ وَالْهَادِ الَّذِي لَا يُضِلْ وَالْمُحَدِّثُ الَّذِي لَا يَكْذِبْ. He said, know that this Quran is an advisor which never deceives. It is a leader which never misleads. It's a narrator which never speaks a lie. So in this period of trials and tribulations, in this period of insecurity, in this period of uncertainty, in this period of fitna, if you will, it's very important to heed the call of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. In a hadith documented by Imam al-Tirmidhi, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Satakunu fitna. There will be trials and tribulations. Sayyidina Ali karramallahu wajha asked, فَمَا الْمَخْرَجْ مِنْهَا يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. So how will we get out of that trial and tribulation? And the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Kitabullah, by the book of Allah. فِيهِ نَبَأَ مَا قَبْلَكُمْ وَخَبَرُ مَا بَعْدَكُمْ وَحُكْمُ مَا بَيْنَكُمْ. This is the Quran, is the source by which you will extricate yourself from that fitna and tribulations and times of difficulty. In other words, he said, this Quran, it has information of the past, news about the present, and guidance and guidelines for the future. فَهُوَ حَبْلُ اللَّهِ الْمَتِينَ وَهُوَ الذِّكْرُ الْحَكِيمُ وَهُوَ الصِّرَاطُ الْمُسْتَقِيمُ. This is the rope of Allah, which if you hold fast to, you will not become divided. حَبْلُ اللَّهِ الْمَتِينَ وَهُوَ الذِّكْرُ الْحَكِيمُ. This is the dhikr. This is the reminder. This is the reminder filled with wisdom. وَهُوَ الصِّرَاطُ الْمُسْتَقِيمُ. You're asking guidance for the right path. This is the right path. And then he said, further on, هو الذي من قال به صدق ومن حكم به عدل ومن عمل به أجر ومن دعا إليه هدي إلى صراط مستقيم. Whoever speaks by the Quran speaks the truth. Whoever judges by the Quran judges with justice. Whoever acts by the Quran will surely be rewarded with the best of rewards. And whoever invites to the Quran, he himself and whoever he is inviting is rightly guided and called into the path of righteousness. So let us value this unique book, this most read book, preserved in its entirety, in its original, most interpreted, most memorized book, a book which is the source of ultimate guidance. If we want to speak to Allah, they say make dua, and if you want Allah to speak to you, then read the Quran. That Quran is accessible to us. When Allah revealed the Quran to Rasulullah, it is for all of humanity, and each one who engages the Quran at a personal level. There are those who look at the Quran, and that's one level of looking. There are those who read the Quran, and that's another level of engaging. Then there are those who read to understand, that's a higher level. But lower level than that are those who read the Quran only to find something to argue with somebody. So they read and understand only the part for argumentation. That's not a good way of doing it. So read, understand, and higher than reading and understanding is implementing it. Living by the Quran, so we imbibe the prophetic personality, the prophetic character. And therefore the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is uswatun hasana. Why? Because he is the personification of the Quran. You don't have to ask the Rasul what the Quran says. When you saw what he did, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you knew what the Quran says. So I always say, Rasulullah is the personification of the Quran, and the Quran is certification of the proof of his prophethood. If you want a certificate, Rasulullah didn't go to any university. What is his certificate? The Quran. It is still there. You haven't seen my certificate. I haven't seen yours. I know you graduated. I graduated. But you haven't seen my certificate. Rasulullah's certificate is one for everyone to see. It is the Quran. So Rasulullah is the personification of the Quran, and the Quran is certification of the proof of his prophethood. Uswatun Hasana, the ideal exemplar. So we understand that though the Quran was revealed at a particular place, at a particular time, لِزَمَانٍ دُونَ زَمَانٍ وَلِمَكَانٍ دُونَ مَكَانٍ, though it was revealed at a particular time and a particular place, its directives, its guidelines, its wisdom is not for a particular time, a particular people, or a particular place. Hence the notion of هُدَى لِلنَّاسِ is for all people, you know, لِزَمَانٍ دُونَ زَمَانٍ وَلِمَكَانٍ دُونَ مَكَانٍ, for all periods and for all places. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us, وَنَزَّلْنَا عَلَيْكَ الْكِتَابَ تِبِيَانًا لِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ وَهُدًى وَرَحْمَةً وَبُشْرَى لِلْمُسْلِمِينَ. We have revealed the Quran, we have revealed in this book a clarification, a clarity of everything. In essence, the fundamentals of things. The Quran is a book of details. Even Salah, for example, it tells you to make Salah. How to make Salah, we find through the example of Rasulullah. So the Quran is not a book of details, it's a book of principles and fundamental guidelines. There are some issues which are detailed, like inheritance and so on, perhaps. But even prayer itself is not detailed in the Quran, though it's one of the pillars. The idea is it's a clarification, but it's a foundation on the basis of which all clarification rests. That is why whenever we make a decision in Islam, we go back, أَطِيعُ اللَّهَ وَأَطِيعُ الرَّسُولُ, to the Quran and the Sunnah, which is the fundamental and primary source of our law. So وَنَزَّلْنَا عَلَيْكَ الْكِتَابَ تِبِيَانًا لِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ. We have revealed unto thee the book as an exposition, as a clarification of all things. وَهُدَى, it is the guide. وَرَحْمَة, it is a mercy. This is very important to understand, and we always say, Allah is Rahman al-Rahim, Rasul is Rahmatan lil Alameen, Quran is Shifa wa Huda wa Rahmah. That Allah is mercy, the Rasul is mercy, the Quran is mercy, and we as people of faith are supposed to reflect that mercy. Very, very important. In engaging the Quran, in reflecting the Quran, if you want to measure for yourself, not to judge other people, but you want to judge yourself, purely yourself, am I really getting the Quran in this Ramadan? Check by the end of Ramadan, until next year and beyond, if you have imbibed the spirit of mercy, have you increased your compassion? That will be an indication, because not only the Quran, even the Rasul and Allah himself are Rahmah, Rahmah, Rahmah. Rahman al-Rahim, Rahmatan lil-Alameen, Shifa'a wa Huda wa Rahmah. So unless and until that Rahmah becomes reflected for yourself, not other people, judge yourself by it. And then you can measure, am I really imbibing the spirit of the Quran, the spirit of Rasulullah? So, وَشِفَاء وَهُدَوْ وَرَحْمَةٍ, it is a guidance and it's a mercy. وَبُشْرَى لِلْمُسْلِمِينَ, it's a hidayah for everybody. وَبُشْرَى لِلْمُسْلِمِينَ, but it gives glad tidings to those who submit to its commands and those who live by its guidelines. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, اللَّهُمَّ نَوِّرْ قُلُوبَنَا بِالْقُرْآنِ وَزَيِّنْ أَخْلَاقَنَا بِالْقُرْآنِ وَنَجِّنَا مِنَ النَّارِ بِالْقُرْآنِ وَأَدْخِلْنَا الْجَنَّةَ بِالْقُرْآنِ. O Allah, enlighten our hearts, or lighten our hearts with the Qur'an. O Allah, adorn and beautify our character through the Qur'an. O Allah, save us from the fire of Jahannam by the Qur'an. And O Allah, let us enter into Jannah with the Qur'an. أَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَأَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهِ وَالسَّلَامُ عَلَيْكُمْ وَرَحْمَةُ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى وَبَرَكَاتُهُ.